neutral zone, smart at the blues.
All eyes peeled on the coach. It's day one of training camp for the Campbell River Storm, and they've got some work to do.
Able to possess the puck down low, 2-on-2. Yeah, I think for us, it hasn't really changed. I think the first thing we look for is good kids. We want to recruit character, and I think when we do that, you know, the hard work part kind of comes easy. You know, I think for us, even though we won bronze last year, it was a bit of a step down from the year before when we won gold. So I think there's still a little bit of revenge on our mind, and I think we want to, you know, take charge and win gold again this year.
It's harder than some games during the regular season because guys are just trying to fight for spots, right? And try to prove themselves here to Lee.
Grueling conditioning between the grueling drills. 10 push-ups followed by 10 sit-ups as fast as you can, followed by 10 burpees. Every move being watched by the coach.
For us, we're looking for separating skills. Obviously here, there's a lot of kids that are pretty similar in terms of what they can bring to the table. Guys that can do that little thing just a little bit better than the guy beside them, whether it's blocking a shot or finishing a check or even things like calling for passes, like minor details that a lot of kids think are kind of for smaller guys and younger ages, but it makes such a difference at our level, and obviously that's something we look for, is the little things. So have one guy weak side slash and chip it off the wall, or just chip it and go get it.
It's a good feeling. It's our first day here, and we're just kind of breaking into things here, and it feels good to be in Campbell River on a new team in a new town. Favorite part of the game, definitely just be winning championships and just being with the guys and really just the camaraderie of that.
We're a fast team. We play quick. I mean, we play structured hockey. You know, we're quick through the neutral zone, and we make teams pay with our speed.
We want to get pucks deep, and we want to play below the hash marks the other team, and want to be a hard team to contain just due to our speed and how dynamic we are offensively. If we don't have the puck, we want to get it back as quick as we can. Fun, exciting hockey, especially for people to come watch. We play hard and we play fast.
First training session almost over, and the deal is the players get a break if Coach Stone doesn't score a goal on either goalie. And they like what they see. Check out CampbellRiverStorm.com for this year's game calendar and latest news with the team. For Go on Shaw TV, I'm Marjorie Greaves.
And we are live at Rod Brind'Amour Arena for Game 1 of the VIJHL 2016-17 season. Number 77, Sheldon Brent, will be wearing 77 in a Storm uniform. Aiden Bake Smith, number 26. Number 88, Colin Blake, just 14 assists away from the Storm all-time assist lead. Kobe Oishi, team captain. Played with the West Shore Wolves last year from Victoria, Chris Smith. Colton Rode from Sherman Oaks. Reed Wilson acquired from the Osoyoos Coyotes. Christian Brandt, who had such a great Cyclone Taylor Cup. Aaron Brewer, fan favorite. Wes Road introducing Barb Byrne, league president. Logan Savard and Kobe Oishi taking the ceremonial draw. Campbell River Storm and the Oceanside Generals to kick off 2016-17. And it's been a long off season. Another big crowd in Campbell River. And we're underway in Campbell River. Oceanside wins the draw back in their own zone. And that's poked out by Kobe Oishi. Kobe Oishi on a 2-on-none. Kobe Oishi in on goal. Scores! Kobe Oishi makes it 1-0. Kobe Oishi scores the first goal of the new season. Campbell River up 1-0. Kobe Oishi, beautiful goal. He had chin with him, and he chose to shoot. And made no mistake. Sutherland keeps it in the neutral zone. Earhart tries to get by his man. Here comes Colin Blake, get on goal, scores! Colin Blake posting in 2-0 at 14:24 left in the first period. Campbell River takes a 2-0 lead. Colin Blake, textbook Colin Blake goal. Just enough to break it up and disrupt the pass. In the Oceanside end, Brandt gets it back to Sutherland. Sutherland with a shot. Oh, scores! I think that was all Sutherland. Posting in, it looks like. Campbell River takes a 3-1 lead with 2:04 left in the period. With a shot, and it's easily handled. Messer taken out into the corner, and Oceanside will get it to the line. Oh, big hit! Big hit by Sheldon Brett, and he lets people know he's here. Here comes Brett. Brett with a nice move, and great work by Powell. Colin Blake slams it in behind the net. Brett centers it, and Earhart had a chance in close. Big hit from Sheldon Brett on Logan Savard, and no doubt they'll represent themselves well, and hopefully Campbell River will be there, or Oceanside, one of the two. Chance for Blake, shot, scores! Sheldon Brett, his first goal as a Campbell River Storm! And Colin Blake, 1 point closer to the all-time Storm assist lead. 3:16 left in the period. Sheldon Brett makes it 4-1. Kyle Ireland will be doing the call on that game. Rhodes. DeBrett with a shot. Quick shot, and it was wide. Chance. Scores. Goes off a general. I'm not sure who got it. Might have been Earhart. It was. But Campbell River has a 5-1 lead. 17:22 left in the period. And it's waved off. Rhodes will pick it up. Rhodes gets by his man. Nice pass up to Earhart. Earhart, he's got Colin Blake with him. Earhart, shot. Oh, rebound. Goes straight to Colin Blake and into the net. Nice goal. Earhart takes the shot. Rebound goes straight to Colin Blake, and Colin Blake is not going to make a mistake from that position. It's 6-1 Campbell River. Colin Blake with his fourth point of the night. Oh, chance! Oh! Chin did everything but score there. And that'll do it. Campbell River Storm opened the 2016-17 account with a 6-1 victory, and we're full value for the win. Shots on goal, 61-15. 61-15, the shots on goal. And from the moment this game started to the moment it finished, Campbell River played hard, finished their checks, and they had the same level of intensity in the third period as they did.
Face off deep in the Islanders' end. Harvey now at the point. Harvey. He's got Williams on the opposite corner. Back to Williams. Good work by Williams to keep it in. Williams to Harvey. Harvey. Shot just in on goal and doesn't get through. Good block in front. Williams. Saucer pass to Harvey. Harvey with a shot. Deflection shot. Scores. Reed Wheeldon makes it 2-0 on the power play.
He still nails his own laundry, and he doesn't talk to females so good. Number one, Chris Smith. Woo! Started on last events. He not only locked the door on his coach, he also locked the door on the BCHL. Number 77, Trevor Bottomley. Woo! Started on last events. The newly minted president of the Dead Poets Society.
Upgrade the old Strathcona Gardens or Rod Brindamore Arena, depending on who you talk to as to when it gets completed, but sometime in the next few years, expunging out that one wall and adding seating on both sides. A little cramp for the 900 plus fans that show up every week for Friday night hockey. And we're underway. Like a veteran out there.
Wow, this goes to a guy who's tripping around with a bird cage out there.
Spinning out of the circle, shoots and scores! Kobe Oishi wins it in double overtime! And the Storm take a 2-0 lead!
My last year in Kelowna, I was playing midget with the Okanagan Rockets. And Lee had contacted me that summer. It wasn't the first time, but he had called me and he was pretty serious about signing me. And I knew it was a good program from Colfron, as he played there the year before. And everything just seemed like it was the right fit. Campbell River welcomed me with open arms, and everything worked out.
Our parents were friends in high school and stuff, so it was kind of like when we were like, when they were friends, they kind of had kids together, so we'd be the same age, so we could play and stuff. We went through kindergarten all the way up to like grade 12 together, playing hockey and baseball together. So yeah, I've kind of, you know, known the guy for a while. Been blessed enough to know the guy.
Showed up to camp. Lee was pretty persistent on me wearing the C throughout the summer. I hadn't really made up my mind. I came to camp and just saw the boys. Saw how excited everyone was for the season, and I just thought it'd be a good idea. I just remember the first time I ever kind of like really talked with Kobe and like bond with him. We were on the bus on way back from, I think it might have been Saanich or Peninsula, so a bit of a longer one. And I just went and sat with him for a while, and like we just kind of talked, and like that was the first time I kind of really got to know Kobe and who he was as a guy, and like. I've been really close with him ever since. Like he's one of my, not just one of my best friends on the team, but one of my best friends that away from the ring.
Kobe was the first guy to introduce himself to me. comes off as the greatest guy. Every game, every practice, he's the hardest working player out there, and you can notice it. He'd take a bullet for every one of us, and that's what makes him the greatest leader on our team.
Best captain in the league, like, you know, everybody respects him. You know, guys on other teams respect him, so, you know, just does a heck of a job up here.
Impressions of Camp River, I thought it was pretty small town. I didn't really know what to expect. I wasn't really used to it. And then the first game in the Brindy, just seeing all those fans going wild, it was pretty special. I knew it was definitely a privilege to play in front of that. Not every team is granted that. So I think we're pretty special to have the people that we do in Campbell River.
Leading scorer for the Campbell River Storm in the playoff. Oh, a chance for Earhart. Raffler, fans on his shot. Good work by Chin as he got his stick in the way. Play in the Nanaimo end. Raffler at the point with a shot. Redirected, Chin scores! Dawson Frank in the blue paint. Traffic in front of the net. That's the key for the Campbell River Storm. They open an early lead. Just what the home fans want. 2 minutes, 35 seconds into the first period, the Campbell River Storm draw first blood, 1-0 on a goal from Dawson Frank. Great work by Frank right in front of the net. A little bit of a rebound in the blue paint. Frank pounces on it, puts it behind Hawthorne, 1-0.
Sutherland. Campbell River still on a power play. Earhart. For another 30 seconds. Kersley over to Sutherland. Sutherland with a shot. Scores! Eden Sutherland! A blast from the point, and that's his second goal of the season. Eden Sutherland scored game one of the season. Campbell River just everything they're touching going in the net. That goal coming at 4:21.
One player that we do know is in the lineup tonight. He was in the season opener, looked fantastic, and that's AP Pierce Messer. What does Pierce bring to the game?
A great shot, you know, good vision for the game. You know, he's a young guy. The guys in our dressing room really, you know, want to cheer for him. You know, they want to see him do well, and when he does do well, when he does something good out there, it gets a lot of energy for our bench. You know, obviously when an AP comes in and contributes, that definitely takes a little bit of the onus off of our older guys, and you know, that's always a good thing for him to come in and you know, get some experience as well. He brings a big shot. He'll most likely be playing on a line with Colin Blake tonight, so he'll be getting that puck in opportunities to shoot the puck. You know, I think he'll have a big one tonight.
They pulled the rookie one. Pierce Messer in the lineup tonight, AP, and the Storm pulled the old trick. Okay, rookie, head out there, and he goes for a lonely skate around. Pierce Messer
two games with the Storm. Actually, though, I only remember one, and that was the season opener. And he looked great in the season opener. Messer couldn't get it. Oh, and that just about snuck through Rook. Campbell River taking shots. Expect a really good effort from the Storm early. Good work by Messer. Messer with a chance. Great work by Messer to steal the puck down low.
Picked up by Bottomley. Bottomley comes out. Bottomley to Messer. Messer, he's got Williams with him. Gets it to Williams. Williams. Williams taken out. Messer centers it. Oh, and a nice play from Messer to set up Blake. And Blake just missed. Messer dumps it in. Oh, and he just missed a hit from Connors. And Messer delivers a hit behind the play. Harvey crosses the line.
Over and West Shore. Colin Blake will take the draw, pushes it forward. Colin Blake. Chance scores! Messer! Colin Blake, his second point of the night, gets it to Messer, and Messer makes no mistake. They want that one. Messer's first junior goal. 13:54 left in the period. You could see that happening all night. Storm players really wanted Pierce Messer to get that goal. They were getting the puck to him every opportunity he had, and makes no mistake with that one. And you know, at that season opener, I'll never forget just what a great game that young man had. And Lamore can't get it out. Blake with it. Blake hit high and out of the play. But Blake gets to do it again. Blake, nice pass! Shot! Scores! That was a beautiful goal. Wouldn't it be nice to see these two guys play together on a regular basis? Colin Blake feeds Pierce Messer with a beautiful goal. I can see that one on YouTube real soon. Messer with his second in a row from Colin Blake. And the first star of the AP, Pierce Messer, two goals tonight, and he looked like a veteran out there.
Yeah, that Messer kid, how about that, eh? Yeah. No, honestly, like, it's... But Blakey's the type of guy, he thinks the game at such a high level offensively that I think... In the past, we always had a couple guys for Blake to play with, whether it was Goldbron or Feeney or Welsh or McNamara. Guys who maybe, as much as you coach, you don't like to see it, maybe give up the D side for some of that high-octane offense. And I think you saw tonight, Messer's a guy that could put the puck in the net. And not only that, but he's a big give-and-go player, which is, I think, exactly what Blakey wants on his line. So definitely some chemistry.
Thankfully, these teams don't play again till Thursday, although the way this game's going, they might just roll it into game number three. Costain against McMullen in the dot. Shot off the face-off wide. Tipped in by Oishi, spinning out of the circle. Shoot the scores! Kobe Oishi wins it in double overtime! And the Storm take a 2-0 lead!
Got Brandt with him. Bottomley gets it to Brandt. Oh, and there's Skates. Chance hit the post. Scores! Sheldon Brett gets the teddy bear toss goal. And Jamie Harris called it. Last night she said it would be Sheldon Brett. And Sheldon Brett with the teddy bear toss goal. Campbell River leads it. 1-0. That goal coming at 10:26 of the first period. I also talked to Sheldon Brett today, and he said, I'm going to get that goal as they were leaving the
Well, Sheldon, you told me you were going to do it before the game, and you came through. How special
was scoring that teddy bear toss goal?
Well, I mean, it was big for me, and it was big for my teammates, you know, get that first one off our breath. Great play by Christian there, and Trevor to make it, set it up. Yeah, I know, I really wanted it from the start there, and once I got it, it was a nice monkey off the back.
The thing that caught me wasn't just you scoring the goal and the reaction from the fans. It was the reactions from your teammates that were so excited for you. How special is this group of guys to you?
Oh, I mean, I've never seen anything like it. I mean, we're all pretty close, and we're all really supportive of one another. And you know, I was really telling the boys before the game I really wanted that goal, and they were saying, go out and prove it. And, you know, when I did, it was just a real joy of excitement for all of us, and I hope it kind of set a spark, and it seemed to have led the way.
Once again, Storm players next week will be distributing these teddy bears and plush toys to the Campbell River Hospital and some senior care residents. They usually go to Yucalta Lodge and Evergreen. So a great community function that these guys do every Christmas. And I know the guys get up for it. You heard Colin Blake talk about it during the pregame show. And, you know, it really does touch them on how much this means to an awful lot of people in the community. So good on the Storm for doing this, and it's a great junior hockey tradition, the teddy bear toss goal. Sheldon Brett with the goal.
At the line. Over he goes. Took a shoulder check, but carried on with the puck. Now coming back with the Pogan is Kersley with the puck. Oh, goodness. One of the Wolves players.
Oh! My goodness. Pickup just hit Earnhardt and shattered the glass. Absolutely shattered the glass.
And destroyed the glass.
All over the timekeeper.
Yeah. So I don't know what we're going to do here. We're going to find an arena attendant. Hopefully they've got a spare piece of glass in there. Or maybe we've got to put a piece of plywood up, Paul.
I don't know. Can they play with it? They can't.
Can't play with it like that.
They got to move the timekeeper, and my goodness.
The game might be delayed and replayed later. Who knows? We don't know what's going to happen here. Yeah.
Oh, no.
That's not true. I had a hot dog. I had one of the best hot dogs in the world. Here's Brent. Takes a shot. Scores.
They scored. Brent.
They did it. They did it.
Big angle.
The Campbell River Storm did it.
Campbell River Storm.
They are champions.
BIJHL champions.
They did it. And they deserve it. And they were the best team in the overtime. I'll tell you that. That was.
Yeah.
They were the best team in the overtime. And the ice surface has been adorned with Campbell River Storm helmets and gloves and equipment, and that's it. And you got tears in the eyes of
Anthony Shiro's getting congratulated by his teammates.
Yeah.
And he feels bad about that goal. I think it came in a bad angle. But
And Kenny Britton is inconsolable right now. He's a lot of tears down there, and you got to feel for these
20-year-olds. The 20-year-olds, definitely. Yeah, Don Colbeans.
And this.
Graydon Hole.
Yeah.
And Jordan Passmore.
But I tell you, the better team in the overtime won the contest, gentlemen, and that's my opinion only. What I mean by that is that, you know.
Well, they outshot the Cougars big time.
Yep, they did.
Plus, they had two.
And they got
two posts and a crossbar.
Yeah, you stole my words. I was going to mention that. The posts and the crossbars. And.
And. Grant is the hero of the day here.
number one.
Into the neutral zone. Here comes Bottomley. Bottomley just dumps it in. He'll go off for a line change. 16:05 left in the first period. 1-0 Campbell River on a goal from Colin Blake. Here comes Brewer. He's got Hikichi going to the net. Shot! Scores! Top corner! Aaron Brewer! And the checking line for the Campbell River Storm comes up big. That goal coming with 15:49 left in the first period.
Number two.
Get along the near wall. Raffler, he'll lose it. Good work by Sproul, but he ends up passing it to Kersley. Kersley backing up in his own zone. Hikichi to Brewer. Good work by Brewer. Brewer, he's got McCann going to the net. Shot, scores! Brewer saves spot his last time. And what the Storm are doing it is firing it directly at the goaltender, and looks like we'll have a goaltending change. Riley Matheson is out. Bryce Scheibel will go in. That's the beauty that the Braves have.
Number three.
Having some internet issues. 28 seconds left in the man advantage for the Campbell River Storm. Shot scores! Aaron Brewer, hat trick. Not bad for a checking line. Wow! 15:40 the time. No kidding. This is supposed to be the checking line tonight, but Aaron Brewer just had that look in his face in the locker room. Congratulations, Aaron Brewer. Probably one of the best games he's played in a Storm uniform, and he's looking incredibly confident tonight.
First of all, Aaron, congratulations on the game that you played. Before the game, Coach Stone came up to you and asked you to do a special assignment. What was it?
It was to unmatch Guerra. And
the thing that I saw from you was a big smile on your face, like you just got the best Christmas present ever. How special was that game for you on Sunday against the Standish Braves?
It was a good game. Like, it was a lot of fun, obviously, and everybody on the team bought in, and That's fun hockey.
You were supposed to be the line matcher, and they ended up having to match your line, and you scored hat trick. Was it one of the best games you played that you can remember?
I can't say games ever went that well for me.
Yeah. In the second period, were you just tired of line matching, and that's why you decided to drop the mitts, or what was it, or first to the shower? What was the story there?
No, Raffler got hit, and then the boys just kind of... tempers flared and some guys wanted to go, so everybody grabbed somebody.
And you already had three goals.
Yeah.
So the rest of the way through, you know, you guys have played some great hockey lately. What do you and your teammates have to do to be successful the rest of the way through, Aaron?
Just keep doing what we've been doing, working hard and playing the right way. We're really buying into the system right now, and that's contributing to our success.
Have you ever played with a group of guys like this?
No, I can't say I have. Especially with my wingers, Hikichi and Dylan right now. It's just they move so fast and teams can't control it.
Congratulations on a really good game and a great season so far, Aaron.
Thank you. I appreciate it, Mark.
Go straight to Smith and Walters. Walters almost steals it, and Brewer had to be sharp to get that puck in front of the net. Brewer with a chance. Nice stop from Hawthorne. Penalty's over. Brewer, he's got some room and some speed. Brewer in behind the net. Centers it. Chance. Daredigger scores. All set up by the work of Aaron Brewer. What a pretty goal. Aaron Brewer held on to that puck for it seemed like an eternity, went for his skate, found Derendinger coming in from the point. Derendinger makes no mistake. Campbell River on the board. 2-1 Nanaimo, 16:22 left in the period. Mitchell Williams will take the draw. He's got Messer and Wheeldon with him. Smith behind his own goal. Williams will get to it. Lamoureux. Chance! Scores! Derendinger! Derendinger moved in from the point, takes a shot. It squeezes through the pads of Red Rook. Campbell River up 1-0. That goal coming with 8:17 left in the first period. Down in Victoria from Powell River, BC, he'll take the draw against Kobe Oishi, deep in the Nanaimo Buccaneers zone. Face off, won by Oishi. Back to the point to Raffler. Raffler gets it to Oishi. Oishi behind in the net to Akichi. Akichi fanned on the pass, still has the puck. He'll stop, change direction. Campbell River will get it back to the point. That's Raffler with it. Raffler, oh, nice deflection. Actually, it was blocked. It went in. It went in off of Akichi. That was a strange one. Went off Akichi. He was looking for the deflection. Went off him straight up in the air, and he eventually gets it in. Campbell River on the power play. They take a 6-5 lead. Carter Akichi. That goal coming at 5:10 of the period on the power play. Carter Akichi.
That was a pretty emotional win. Like, if you watch that fifth goal, it took one of the wildest, weirdest bounces I've ever seen, and Carter Akichi scored.
Yeah.
And we talked about it after and in the room. Safe to say there was someone watching over Carter today with that bounce, for sure. Pretty emotional win for him.
Well, that puck must have gone 15 feet in the air.
For sure.
Yeah, it was incredible.
There was someone looking over that puck. That's all we have to say about that, for sure.
Awesome.
And it's pretty cool for him to get the puck after the game and the shovel, and it's a pretty emotional moment in the dressing room, to be honest, and it's pretty safe to say that the boys are all doing it for him and each other, for sure.
Carter Akichi. That was a strange one. That puck must have gone 10, 15 feet in the air. Lands in the blue paint, and the Storm capitalized. Carter Akichi.
Here comes McCartney. McCartney passed to Williams. Williams poked off his stick. Williams, cross-ice pass. Craddock. Looks for Blake. Blake crosses the line. Nice pass to Mitchell Williams. Mitchell Williams reverses direction. Nice work by Mitchell Williams in the corner. Centered! And Colin Blake couldn't pull the trigger. Back to the point. Here comes Raffler. Raffler's shot scores! Ben Raffler! Ben Raffler makes it 1-0 at exactly 8 minutes. For Raffler, that's his first goal of the season.
Absolutely great shot by Raffler against his old team. You know, he wanted to get that, especially against his old Michigan friend, Derek Smith, who was out there on that play. Great shot, top corner, no mistake by Raffler.
It came down to just one vote, but with 36% of the fans' votes, the goal of the week goes to number 15, Dylan McCann, and this great individual effort.
Campbell River makes a change. Out for them is McCann, Brett, Raffler, Derendinger, and Bottomley. Nice pass up for McCann. Brett looks to streak in. McCann takes that. Cuts up to the middle. McCann takes that. Fans on the shot. Hansen plays that out wide. Dylan McCann spins away from Braden Hansen. In comes McCann. What a shot! Oh my goodness! He put that. I don't know if you could put that any better if you tried. Dylan McCann spun away from Braden Hansen, and he put that beautifully in the top left corner. And it's a 4-1 lead for the Campbell River Storm.
That was an extreme example of individual effort. He went from the left side to the right side and kept the puck on his stick.
Great job, though, by McCann. What a
Absolutely.
Shot.
Absolutely, yeah. He's been a difference maker in the game today.
Get
Merrill's pressing. Can't put it home. Harvey keeps the play alive. Wrist shot saved by Woolick. Another chance, and Woolick makes the save. Dawson Frank chips it around the defender. Dawson Frank coming in. Frank to the net, scores! The kid is hot tonight!
What an effort by Dawson Frank. He got the puck. He had a breakaway from a far blue line on in. Just went in on defender, battled it off, and got it by David Anderson, despite the fact there's a defender right on him. Great goal by Dawson Frank.
Oh, my goodness. Frank looked like a four-year VIJHL veteran there. He had the poise to chip it around the defender. Knew another defender was coming to angle him off, and he had one mission, and that was a nose to the net.
Shot through traffic. Oh, good screen in front of the net. Schubert was positioned really well. I don't think Chris Smith saw it. Goes all the way down the ice, straight on to Hawthorne. Hawthorne, Clayton Peace. He's got Hards after him. Good work by Hards and Peace. Good steal by Hards with a chance. Scores! What a steal! Shorthanded. Campbell River Storm score. Darren Hards with an incredible steal behind the net. As the defender went down, Hard stayed on it, went around the net, just outweighed John Hawthorne, and we have a 2-1 game with the Storm replying with a shorthanded goal in the second period. That goal coming at 3:54. That'll be no doubt, it'll be Hard's unassisted.
Passes it off to Billy Walters. Walters goes to the front of the net. Oh, and a chance, and it just went by the blue paint. Good work by Heathcote in deep. Campbell River can't get it out. Oh, they will. Here comes Colin Blake. Colin Blake with Mitchell Williams. 2-on-1 to Mitchell Williams with a chance. Shot scores! Mitchell Williams in double overtime. Mitch is back. The Campbell River Storm take game one. 3-2 at 2:32 of double overtime. Colin Blake, Mitchell Williams, back of the net. And the Storm have a 1-0 series lead. And how about the Nanaimo Buccaneers? What a performance from them tonight and their goaltender, John Hawthorne.
On the post-game show, talking to the hero of the night, game one, Mitchell Williams. Mitchell, your first game back from injury. Before we talk about the goal, let's talk about how you felt. How did it feel getting out there tonight?
Obviously amazing. Like, I've wanted to be back on the ice so much recently. At one point, I tweaked it a little bit and I had to sit down, but just rejuvenated and got back out there.
The Buccaneers played a heck of a game tonight, didn't they?
Oh, definitely. Hawthorne, he was unreal tonight, for sure.
Let's talk about the goal. Colin Blake sets it up, and that's right in your wheelhouse, isn't it? How did it feel getting the puck? And talk about putting it in the back of the net and what happened after.
As soon as I looked up and there was only one D and me and Colin, I was like, this is something's here. And as soon as he hit my stick, I just put in the short side, and I can't thank him enough. I can't thank like the boys enough for just, that was a hard fought game from all the boys for sure.
You guys are back at it Thursday night at the Nanaimo Ice Center. What are the keys to the game from your perspective?
Play the full 60 like we just did for sure. Like, that game definitely set a tone for us for this series, and I think we need to keep it up.
Thank you very much, and congratulations on the win, and it's nice to have you back in the lineup.
Thank you very much.
Bucks again stand up at their blue line. Shots are 12-7 in favor of the visitors, but it is the home side with the lead here in Nanaimo. Here's a turnover. Richardson with a chance right in. Chips it on goal. It pops in the air, and it's knocked over the net by Anderson. Incredible save, whether it was a fluke or not. That puck looked like it was going to drop in the net. And Anderson flailed his left arm up in the air and swatted it over the net. It looked like to me that was going to drop in.
I'm calling it a blind a blind save, because when he threw, like you said, when he threw his arm up, it was behind him. He could not see that puck. He was just, I think, guessing where it was.
Here's Williams with a shot, and he scores right through Hawthorne.
Harvey keeps it in. Messer. Messer's been all over the ice tonight. Great AP. He will not be playing Junior B hockey, no doubt about it. When he gets the call, it'll be Junior A at the very least. Back to, and Colin Blake elected to pass. He had a great opportunity on goal and looking for the assist. That's what Blake does. Colin Blake. Oh, nice pass to Harvey. Shot scores! Josh Harvey makes it 4-0 on a brilliant pass from Colin Blake. 14:38 left in the third period. The Campbell River Storm with a 4-0 lead. That's Harvey's third point of the night. And Colin Blake gets on the board.
with 43% of the vote. The goal of the week goes to number 7, Brett Kinley, coming out of the penalty box with the game-winning goal against the Buccaneers.
Heathcote with the block. Here's a chance. Back to Heathcote. He's out in front of the net. Broken up by the Storm. Poked out. And the penalty's now over. 5 aside. The Buccaneers still with pressure. Here comes Brett Kinley on a breakaway. Brett Kinley on the break. Brett Kinley shot. Scores! Brett Kinley on the breakaway. The Campbell River Storm take a 3-2 lead. Brett Kinley roofed it right under the crossbar. The Campbell River Storm lead 3-2 with 5:48 left in the third period. That's the 40th shot on goal.
Brett Kinley scored the game-winning goal in a war with the Nanaimo Buccaneers. Probably the best game we've seen at the Brindy this season. Brett, talk a little bit about the goal. It was a beauty.
Yeah, it got out of the box there and fortunately stole it off Heathcote and went in on a breakaway and it was rolling. But I was lucky enough to get it up and it went in. So yeah,
right
it was
under
nice
the crossbar.
Yeah, it was nice.
Keys to success the rest of the way through.
Everybody buying in, everybody working hard, everybody showing up every day. And if we do that, we'll get success.
Congratulations on the first start tonight and the game-winning goal and a great season so far, Brett. Thank you very much for doing this.
Thanks, Mark. Appreciate it.
Brett Kinley. 3-2, Campbell River. To Blake. Blake. Derendinger with a shot. Just goes wide. Blake at the point. Blake into the skates. Cougars try and get it out. Blake saves it at the line. Blake. Blake. To Derendinger. Doishi. Goes through, scores! Might have gone off a Cougar. Campbell River scores on the 5-on-3. Doishi with the goal, the captain. I think it went off a Cougar into the net. And this one's tied up. That goal.
It went wide, Bottomley will pick it up on the other side. Played down to Brewer. Brewer now. Cross-ice pass. Touch pass to Oishi. Wrist shot from the point, and he buries that one. Oishi. No problem that time as Kobe Oishi scores power play goal number one and goal number one here for the Storm. Only 40 seconds into their man advantage and just under 5 minutes into this game. 15:47 to go here in the first, and the Storm take the lead.
Colin Blake crosses the line. Colin Blake. There's Messer. Shot from us. Oh, and the rebound went right out in front. And McCartney. McCartney with a hard hit on his man. And good angle on McCartney there. McCartney. Center to blue line. He's at center ice. Fans on the pass. He was looking for Brewer and Villio. Elijah Villio being hounded by Brewer.
It down. Bottomley now will skate him behind his own goal. Trey Watson loses his stick. Bottomley, he loves to do this. Skate the puck from his own zone. He comes all the way into the Nanaimo zone. Gets a shot away, but it's blocked. Storm with a second opportunity, and that's stopped by Hawthorne. A third opportunity, and they score. Sheldon Brett with the overtime winner. That was a knuckler of a shot from number 71. And it goes over the glove hand of John Hawthorne. And the Campbell River Storm take game two in double overtime, 3-2 over the Nanaimo Buccaneers, and the Storm now with a 2-0
series lead.
A tough one for the Buccaneers. Great effort, good battle there, but Sheldon Brett takes a shot, and it looked like it just kind of trickled past John Hawthorne. It looked like numerous Buccaneers players made desperate attempts to stop it, but bottom line is it ended up into the net.
On the postgame show, talking with number 71, Sheldon Brett, the hero of game two, scored the overtime winner just over 4 minutes into the second overtime. You want to describe the goal for us, Sheldon?
Yeah, I mean, Bottomley made a nice play there. He wheeled the puck up over the zone, made a nice play, took a shot, went off a shin pad, and then Kobe came in the high slot, seemed to retrieve the puck, and then he tried to get a shot, couldn't go through, and I just ended up finding the open puck and just shot it, closed my eyes, and next thing you know, I see Brownie saying it's a goal, so I'm pretty happy about that.
Are those the type of goals you have to score in the playoffs?
I mean, there's so many different types of goals you can get in the playoffs. It doesn't really matter how it goes in the end. I mean, as long as we can keep playing a team game and just keep moving forward together, that's all we can ask for.
As a 20-year-old, how special was this time for you?
Honestly, I'm not even going to lie, it's probably the greatest moment of my life scoring that goal. I mean, I can't even remember the last time I've had a goal like that, so it's pretty special to me being 20 and all.
What do you guys have to do to finish the Nanaimo Buccaneers? They've got an awful lot of fight in them.
Oh, yeah, I mean, they're an aggressive team. They come out with a lot of fight for sure, but we just got to stick to our game plan and keep playing our game, and hopefully we can take care of them.
Thank you very much, Sheldon.
Thank you, Mark.
Help out his teammate. Wrapped it around the boards, but unable to get it out. Frank now has it again in the left corner. He's in a battle there with Harding. Dylan McCann will come pick it up. Pass right in front there to Kersley. Kersley picks up his own rebound and makes it 5-3. Gergane with the first save. And the Storm now with five unanswered goals have a 5-3 lead over the Oceanside Generals. Logan Kersley came in from the blue line. The first shot, Gergane stopped it, but Kersley picks up that rebound and finds the back of the net. For Logan Kersley, that's his first goal. That'll be his first ever VIJHL goal.
Gollymore, and he were duking it out for the puck, and here comes Stafford Beal. Stafford Beal dumps it in the corner. He'll chase it down. Kersley gets to it first. Good work by Stafford Beal. Out in front. Oh, and that was a close call.
Yeah, it looked like Aaron Brewer just sold that away from the stick of Jack McMillan as they come in 3-on-1.
Jollymore with a chance. Scores! Connor Jollymore! Makes it a 3-1 game.
Great job for Jolly Morris. This is his first game playing for you guys?
No, he's played a couple of games, and he's been dynamite every game. But I believe this is his first goal.
Yeah, as they collect the puck there. So another goal for you guys. 3 goals, 10 shots. Keeping up a nice little trend here, you know. Nice response off the Panther goal that tied it up. And just right there, you showed that 3-on-1. Nice job by Aaron Brewer. Starting in your own zone, stole it from Jack McMillan. And Jolly Moore followed him up ice on the 3-on-1 and came in as a trailer and scored.
I thought Connor Jollymore not only came in and did a job, but I thought he made that line actually better. You know, he moved the puck really well, protected the puck. So, yeah, those three guys together were really good for sure.
Yeah, he got the goal, but he could have got more goals. And it wasn't just the scoring that impressed you about him. It's just where he is on the ice, and he seems to have really good hockey smarts.
Yeah, definitely a very intelligent hockey player. Obviously, you know, I've said it a couple times, but comes from a program at BWC where, you know, Mako and the coaches there do a really good job of developing their players. And obviously, we've had a ton of success with Burnaby Winter Cup players coming in here. And you know, I think the thing about them is they play the game the right way. And probably most importantly, kids that come out of that program are good kids. You know, you look back at Wellick and Welsh and Derendinger and Raffler. I mean, I can keep going. Chin, like, so many kids that came through that program, every single one of them, you talk about how they're good kids, and I think that stretches right through to Connor Jollymore too.
And the AP, Connor Jollymore, second star tonight. And on behalf of the crew here in Campbell River, myself, Mark Berry, along with Will Bryant from the Peninsula Panthers, and our cameraman, James Scheer. You have yourself a good night, and thank you from Campbell River.
Cross ice, good play ahead to Blake. Blake now driving to the net. Blake on the back end. Colin Blake wins the hockey game. Storm win 4-3.
In a selfish opportunity, which that was not.
Absolutely.
The coach is going to, you're going to have the earring of the coach. Here's Frank here. He's been solid.
Hasn't he?
Boy, he's been impressive.
Good young player.
Boy, very dangerous. They almost got another one on the even strength there. Oh. And speak of the devil, there's Earhart firing another dangerous puck. They outplayed and outclassed, I'm afraid to say, Mark Berry, have been these Saanich Braves tonight. They've been outplayed in their own building by these visiting Storm.
I think this is the best game that the Campbell River Storm have played this season.
They very nearly put another one away, and they do! Late goal there, even strength, Zach Earhart.
On your pregame show, you heard Coach Stone talk about how important this game was to the Storm, because they felt they were underdogs coming into this game.
They really did.
Because of the way Saanich has played them so well.
The exact words he had.
Shot that he had earlier, it kind of handcuffed Matheson. Koyoishi will take the draw, won by Saanich. Grouchy with it, gets it up to Henderson, he'll lose it. Here comes Bottomley along the boards. Bottomley in the corner, goes to the front of the net, shot scores! Trevor Bottomley, beautiful play as he goes into the corner, comes out in front of the blue paint, and just puts it over the shoulder of Bryce Scheibel. The Campbell River Storm off to an absolutely spectacular start. 4-1 the score, Trevor Bottomley with a beautiful goal, and Coach Stone is looking like a genius putting him up front. That goal coming just 13 seconds after Aaron Brewer made it 3-1. Trevor Bottomley makes it 4-1. Gets it off to Ray Arthur. Ray Arthur at the circle, in behind the net. Ray Arthur tries to feed it to the front of the net, where Mitch Cook was positioned. Campbell River tries to get it out. They can't. Savard centers it into the skates of Bottomley. Bottomley. Oh, what a save from Chris Smith! As Chris Smith
was just diving everywhere. And here comes Mitchell Williams. Mitchell Williams on a breakaway. Mitchell Williams poked off his stick. And I still can't get over that Chris Smith save at the other end of the ice. 6:06 left in the period. Chaddock with a shot. Pad save from Chris Smith. Generals, that's Chaddock. Gets it to Savard in the corner. Campbell River looks a little rattled. Harvey. Center of the ice. Goes off of Adams. Good block by Adams. And Harvey has to go back and retrieve the puck. 1:37 left in the power play. Sheldon Brett with the puck in his own zone. Gets it to Colin Blake. Colin Blake crosses the line. Colin Blake goes to open ice. Colin Blake to Brett. Shot. Scores. That's it. Colin Blake has done it. Colin Blake is now the all-time points leader for the Campbell River Storm on a goal from Sheldon Brett. Colin Blake in the Storm history books. Wow. Who thought when that 16-year-old reported to training camp in 2012 that he would be going into the Storm history book. Lee Stone tells his story that when Colin Blake, this was before even Lee Stone was on the scene, but the ladies at the registration booth, when Colin Blake went up for training camp, they asked if he was there to see his big brother. Colin Blake with the assist on a nice goal from Sheldon Brett.
Tonight, Cheryl Taylor made up something very special, and on Saturday night we had our annual scholarship auction and fundraiser. And it was a fierce battle going on between Lynda and Ron, Blakey's dad, to win this thing. And she actually outbid his own father. So thanks for doing that, both of you. So we have here tonight probably three of the most important people in Blakey's life. I know there's more here, but all of his parents are here, all three. His mother, his father, and his billet mom of 5 years. Lynda, you want to make your presentation? A very significant puck.
Talking with number 88, Colin Blake, following a 5-1 victory and a very important date in Campbell River Storm history. Colin Blake breaking the all-time Storm scoring record. He's now at 267. Colin, how does it feel to finally break that record?
It's finally off my back. You know, I don't have to worry about it anymore. It's surreal. I said that earlier in the year that I didn't think I'd actually do it ever. Yeah. But here it is, and I'm just, yeah, it's an honor.
Isn't it kind of ironic? Would you have ever imagined a couple of years ago that you'd be setting up Sheldon Brett for that goal?
Yeah, that's kind of funny because, like, he played for Comox, and me and him didn't really get along.
That's right.
But, no, like, I just found him. He was on, like, pretty much a breakaway, and I was happy that he scored it. And I'll remember it, and I could probably talk about it later in life.
And your 267th point was a beautiful goal. Just caught the corner. Nice goal. You guys have gotten an awful lot of hockey for the remainder of the week. What do you guys need to do to be successful and take first overall?
We need to just stick to our game, you know, take care of our bodies. We got, I think, 5 games here or 4 more throughout the week. So we just got to, you know, come prepared and stay in the lineup, not get into the shenanigans and stuff like that, and just make sure we have a full lineup every night.
And last question about the record. How special was it breaking it with your folks in the audience?
Yeah, it was nice that they could be here, you know, with the cancellation of the game in Nanaimo, and they were coming this weekend. It makes it extra special that my whole family was here to see it.
Congratulations, and Good luck the rest of the way through.
Awesome. Thank you.
Colin Blake. Colin Blake crosses the line. Colin Blake goes to open ice. Colin Blake to Britt. Shot. Scores. That's it. Colin Blake has done it. Colin Blake is now the all-time points leader for the Campbell River Storm on a goal from Sheldon Britt. Colin Blake in the Storm history books. Wow.
Try and help out. They'll try and dig it out. 1:14 left in the extra period. And I think they're looking for a whistle, but they're not going to get one. There's Williams. Williams back to the point to Bottomley. Bottomley through traffic. Nice pad save from Rodin. Back to the point to Bottomley. Bottomley. He'll take the shot through traffic. Bounces off a bunch of players. There's a chance. Shot. Scores. Mitchell Williams. And the Campbell River Storm are going to the gold medal game. What a spirited affair, and you can see the Kodiaks are absolutely devastated by that. Dawson Rodin face down in his goal. Campbell River Storm celebrating. They can do no worse than silver medal and hope to be making the trip to Aarborg. And what a spirited affair, and an absolutely cracker game from start to finish by these two teams.
Firing that one in, Blake Fanning on his shot. The Hawks captain, McCoy Howell, sending that over for Terpsma. That's up at the line, and here comes Swanson. It's a cross-ice dump into the corner. It comes to number 18, Mitch Foyle, but it's turned over by Foyle. McCartney going back the other way. He's got Messer with him, passes over to the AP, and a sharp shot, he scores!
Oh, Messer, what a shot!
Wow.
And the AP strikes again. 28 seconds into the first period, the Campbell River Storm strike first.
Do you think they heard me call them underdogs?
What a shot that was by the AP.
That's poked away from him. Brett, the lone forechecker, has turned over Hickachy. He moves into the shot. He scores! Short-handed!
Connor Hickachy, short-handed. And he's just had a whale of a playoff for the Campbell River Storm.
That will be unassisted.
Just looking over at the coaches there, the tall fella right beside number 33,
yep.
Brendan Enns, of course, 2 years ago, he got gold at the Cyclone Taylor Cup as a coach. He's had bronze and silver, so for 3 years in a row.
Good for him.
And, of course, Cammy was talking about him in the first game, how when he played with the Border Bruins, he broke,
Murray.
Yeah.
One of the Creston players.
Yeah.
Had a Gordie Howe hat trick and ended up breaking his collarbone.
And there's Braden McCartney. Stepped onto the ice at the Brindy in Campbell River at the age of 2. Decided he wanted to play in his hometown. Goaltender Chris Smith, VIJHL Goaltender of the Year from Victoria. Sheldon Brett out of Comox, number 71. And a nemesis of the Campbell River Storm for so many years with the Glacier Kings, and played a couple of seasons with the Trail Smoke Eaters. From Kelowna, number 77, Trevor Bottomley. He was part of that winning team 2 years ago, played on a defensive pairing with Andy Stevens, who now plays for the Powell River Kings. Aaron Brewer, who was with the Nelson Leaves when the Storm won the big trophy, and he said it just absolutely tore his heart apart. He wanted to be a part of the franchise again. Darren Hartz from Prince George, along with another Prince George fella, Mitch Williams, both those two players with BCHL experience. Dawson Frank from Campbell River, number 43, a character on the team and really well loved. And from Port Alberni, Josh Harvey, number 12, who played with the Generals for so many years in the BIJHL. And here's a true champion, Captain Kobayashi, midget champion, BC, 3 years in a row. He's medaled every year as a junior. And number 14, Logan Kersley, and I don't expect to see him in Junior B next year. Yeah. Dylan McCann out of the PGHL came over last season and spent a little time in the SJ this season before coming back. Christian Brandt from Cowichan Valley played with the West Shore Wolves for years and then back with Campbell River for the past two. Max Derendinger, former Nelson Leaf with the Campbell River Storm, and great, great defenseman. Ben Raffler played 20 games with the Powell River Kings this season and is that close to making BCHL, and I expect he'll be there next year. The all-time points, career points leader for the Campbell River Storm, along with assist number 88, Colin Blake, and really, as far as I'm concerned, the hero of the Campbell River Storm, Carter Hickachy, who played through incredible injuries, and he was in agony from the first period on today. Zach Ayer Hart from the Okanagan Rockets last season had a great season. Chase Anderson from the Cary Park Islanders joined the team at the trade deadline. And then, wow, Pierce Messer, what a great, great AP for the Campbell River Storm. Brett Kinley, who was really missed in this series in the last few games, he was a great two-way player, a hero for the Storm last season, had a great season from Powell River. Aiden Sutherland, not in the lineup, had some action last night. And Reed Wheeldon from Comox played in the OHA program down in Penticton. And then we have Spencer Deacon, AP, goaltender out of the Nanaimo system, the Nanaimo or the North Island Silvertips. And his teammate from the Silvertips, Mateus Del Monte, a big defenseman. And now the coaching staff, Lee Stone, along with Mike Wilson and Brendan Enns. And then also in the lineup behind them is Tyson Hernick. He's equipment manager. And the guy that guys all love, the guy at the back of the line, Larry Adams, who is a trainer, wraps them up and tapes them up. And just a great guy in the room for cheering guys up that may be having a bad shift. And Campbell River Storm now silver medalist at the Cyclone Taylor Cup. And I'm just saying on behalf of, I know everybody back home in Campbell River, we are so proud of you. You represented the VIJHL so well. You represented the community well. You represented yourself and your families well. And we're very, very proud of you.
By Kobayashi on a 2-on-none. Kobayashi in on goal. Scores! Kobayashi makes it. Dawson Frank off the wall. Oishi back to Frank. Frank, shot, scores! Centers a chance. Derringer scores! All set up by the work of Aaron Brewer. Frank gets by his man. Frank in on goal to Brandt. Brandt with a shot, scores! Christian Brandt. Earhart tries to get by his man. Here comes Colin Blake. Colin Blake in on goal, scores! Colin Blake posting in.